You're alive. I'm alive. How is this possible? True. Seems like we're the lucky ones, judging by all the corpses strewn about. I remember the ship. I remember falling. Then nothing. You might want to reconsider calling her a friend. Looks like she ran off without us. You're more concerned for her than she is for you, clearly. We need to take care of ourselves. First things first, we need supplies, shelter, and most of all, a healer. We might have escaped, but we still have these little monsters in our heads. No, I don't recognize this place. But anything's an improvement on where we just came from. We need each other, and we both know what's at stake. Can't think of better company. One thing, just before we go. I wanted to thank you again for freeing me. It would have been all too easy for you to run right past my pod, but you didn't. I'll remember that. Lead the way.
Inside. Room for more? Fresh water. There must be a settlement nearby. anything of use?
More of those wretched things.
That open easily. Maybe there's another entrance.
Vicious filth. Best keep some distance or this will be a short fight.
I won't give in.
Important is ever easy.
I'm ready.
Well, so much for peace. Time to push my luck again.
You fight well. Perhaps our survival isn't such a distant prospect.
For me. A mind flayer. And it's hurt.
That thing's bound to be dangerous, even if injured. Best be careful.
You approach the dying monster. This is the thing that abducted you. You could end its life here and now, if only you didn't feel compassion. Compassion. You feel hate, and you deserve to be punished for it. You should be whipped, made to bow before this creature in shame. It's possessing your mind, forcing you to love it, but then the feeling slips. The creature's mind seems to focus elsewhere. Your mind's fuse, lusting for something that is gone. But then its grip claws back with a vengeance, a vice locking your mind into obedience. It needs sustenance to survive, and with your very body, you can provide. The monster lies exhausted, defeated. Its eyes, wet orange pearls, radiate malice.
I've got one of those brain things cornered. There, in the grass. You can kill it, can't you? Like you killed the others? There. Can you see it? You want to keep that darling neck of yours. And you, keep your distance. No need for this to get messy.
I need him alive. Stow that blade, or I'll show you just how messy things can get.
Promises, promises. But I have other business, I'm afraid. Now, I saw you on the ship, didn't I? Nod. Don't lie to me.
Your mind twists. You're looking out of unfamiliar eyes, prowling dark, busy streets. You try to hold the memory, but it fades to the worm. The light, the fear.
What was that? What's going on? You're not one of them. They took you. Just the same as me. And to think, I was ready to decorate the ground with your innards. Apologies. Indeed we are. Please, allow me to introduce myself. My name's Astarion. I was in Baldur's Gate when those beasts snatched me. Is that so? We clearly move in different circles. So, do you know anything about these worms? Turn us into... Ha! Of course it'll turn me into a monster. What else did I expect? Although, it hasn't happened yet. If we can find an expert, someone that can control these things, there might still be time. Well, yes, of course. But first things first. You know, I was ready to go this alone. But maybe sticking with the herd isn't such a bad idea. And you seem like a useful person to know. All right. I accept. Lead on.